You gonna help me preaching here? Can I give you a scripture to help you? This is what Paul says, and we know that all things work together for them that love God and are called according to his purpose. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, quit crying. Quit weeping, because God will answer only according to his purpose. Brothers and sisters, and look what God says to Habakkuk. He does not say anything profound, Dr. Arden. He does not say anything so prolific. This is what he tells Habakkuk to do while he's trying to plead and petition God about the wicked. Uh-huh. He gives him one word. He says, wait. This is what he says. In other words, he says, wait it out while I work it out. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, wait it out while he works it out. He doesn't say anything profound or prolific. He just says to Habakkuk, he says, Habakkuk, I got this. You just wait. My brothers and sisters, the same answer he gives Habakkuk, he's giving us. In other words, while we are in protest about the wicked glee and gain, you need to be busy serving while waiting. Look at what Isaiah says in the 40th chapter as I hurry on to my close. He says in Isaiah chapter 40, he says it like this. He says, they that wait, do I have any Bible readers? Upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not get weary. They shall walk and not faint. Let me help you real quick, because I can help you and preach this text if I really wanted to. What Isaiah is saying in this text, he's saying, one, there's anticipation. Because they that wait. And then second in the text is rejuvenation. Shall renew their strength. And then third, he says, there's elevation. They shall mount up. And then fourth, he says, there's motivation. Because they shall walk and not get weary. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, everything I need is in waiting. I found your neighbor and say, neighbor, wait it out while he works it out. Let me preach it here, Lord.
Preach
more. Can I preach on a little bit further? Look at the text. Look at the text. Because Habakkuk is going to get us to move from yet I will to yes I will. My brothers and sisters, so in the text he says to Habakkuk in chapter 2, verse number 2. Look at the text. He says it. He says, this is the key to you waiting. While you are waiting, write the vision. And make it. That they may run that read it. For the vision is far and appointed.
Y'all said I hear you, boy.
At the end it shall speak, and not wait, though it tarry, wait for it. Because it will surely come. And my brothers and sisters, And then this is the major piece in the text.
Dawson.
Verse number 4. Be part of verse number 4.
I hear you, boy.
This is how he messes us up. He says, the just shall live.
Yes, sir.
By faith. No. Don't miss it now, because the text says something very different than another text, because many of you will say, the just walk. By faith. No, it didn't say just walk. It says inhale and exhale faith. Y'all missed that. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I inhale and exhale faith. He says, the just shall live by faith. Let me help you. In other words, faith sees beyond what they see. Faith expects the unexpected. Faith believes the unbelievable. Faith is willing to do the impossible. My brothers and sisters, I need to help you real quick before we move on further in the text. The Lord requires us to live by faith.
Yeah.
If your neighbor don't see it, so be it. If they don't see greater is coming, so be it. If they don't see the best is yet to come, so be it. If they don't see your latter days shall be greater than your former days, so be it. The reason I'm expecting greater is because I live by faith. I find your name and say, neighbor, I live by faith. Stay with me, sit down. Here's the golden nugget. Here's the golden nugget. I'm not there yet. I'm not there. I'm getting there. Here's the golden nugget in the text. God is saying, in the misery and mess of life, when problems are pouring upon you, hold on to this golden nugget. That the righteous or the just live by faith. In other words, trust me when you can't trace me. In other words, hold on to me because I got you and I got this. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, God has you and he has your situation. Matter of fact, this is what he says in your waiting. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. He says in your waiting, fret not yourself because of evildoers, neither be thou envious of the workers of iniquity. He says this in your waiting. He says many of the afflictions are the righteous, but I will deliver you out of them all. He says in your waiting, I am your shepherd, and you don't have to work for anything. He says in your waiting, the Lord is my life and my salvation. Whom shall I fear?